Hey guys, so today I wanted to do a quick tutorial on how you can easily create a nice looking website with Wix. So if you haven't got started with Wix already, I'll include a link in the description along with any deals, discounts, or promotions going on. So as always, you guys can save as much money as possible. Now, once you go through the process of actually signing up, it's really easy. You can just put in your username and password. And again, it's pretty straightforward and easy to do. Then you'll have the option to choose a template. Now, you'll want to choose a category that fits your website the best. For example, if you want a website that showcases your music or promotes your band or your business, you can find one that would be related to that. Now, I'm currently in need of a professional education website, so I'm going to go ahead and click on Other. So here you're provided with a bunch of stylish website templates based on your category. So you can scroll through all the pages, find the template you like the best. You have the option to first view a template to get a sense of how it will look on your website. And I like the layout of this one, so I'm going to go ahead and click on the Edit button in the corner. So for me, my favorite functionality in Wix is the drag and drop feature of any of the elements you see on a page. So there's no coding required. You simply drag and drop text, images, menus, and galleries to any location you want. You'll be given options to manipulate it however you wish. But first, let's start with the page background. So you can click on the background and change the page design here. Or the page background here. Page background allows you to change the color. Image or video of the background, and Wix does provide awesome stock photos and videos for you to use for your background. Now, if you have a video you would like to use, you can go ahead and click on Upload Video, select the video, upload it, and then click Change Background. Now, the size limit for the video is 50 megabytes, but we can now preview our site here to see the video background in action, which is pretty cool. You can also find the background options in the menu bar on the left. Now, I want to change the title of the website, so let me first ungroup these text boxes. You'll want to double-click on the text box or click on Edit Text. You can change the font size, and resize the text boxes using the lines and small circles. Now, you can group multiple elements or items on a Mac. You're going to hold the Command button and then click, and then for PCs, you're going to press Control and then click. And then after selecting multiple elements, the Group Elements button will appear. And you can also choose to animate your elements as well. You can delete an element by clicking on it and then pressing Delete on your keyboard. So let's go ahead and save what we have so far. Now to add the logo of my site, I'll go to the Add section on the left, go to Image and Image Uploads, and then select an image. You can also upload an image from your computer. Now, seeing that there's some extra space here, I'm going to add a photo gallery. So to do this, go back to Add Gallery and select the gallery. I'll add the slideshow strip and place it at the top. Click on it to change the images and add effects. You can upload or select your images and then click Done. In settings, you have the option to autoplay and indicate the amount of seconds between each image. And I kind of want a filtered effect to my images in the slideshow. So what I can do is add a strip background. You have a lot of elegantly designed strips, but for my purposes, I'm going to choose the classic white and then place it over my slideshow. Click on Change Strip Background, go to Settings, and then change the opacity. You can also include a video from YouTube or Vimeo. Double-click on the video and then search for a video, or you can type in the URL of a specific video. You have the option to autoplay, loop, and also take away controls. There will be times when you want an element and everything below it to go up or down. So to do this, click on the element or elements and drag the drag handle. As you can see, everything below what you selected gets dragged up or down. You can view all your web pages up here. Rearrange any of the pages and rename them by double-clicking. You can add a page here to change its info, like the name, hide it from the menu, or set it as your homepage. You can also choose the layout, add restrictions, and add SEO information to help people better find your page on search engines. I want this blog page to be fifth in the menu at the top. Simply click here and drag the page to the specific location. Now, Wix allows you to integrate a blog into your site. So go back to Add Blog and choose a layout. Manage your blog here or add a new blog post. If you have social media accounts for your brand or company, I do recommend going to add social and then adding a social bar. Here you also have the option to include cool social media widgets and buttons. So drag the social bar into any location. Click set social links and then add a link to each icon. You don't have to use these icons. You can upload your own if you have them on your computer. And then up next is the very popular Wix app market. Here you can insert apps that enrich your website and provide more functionalities. For example, you can add a chat feature and online store booking features, apps for restaurants, marketing, and even music. But right now, I'll show you how to add the Instagram app. But first, I will need to decide which page I want to place that on. So I think I'll place it under the work page. The crosstown I hear indicates that you can't see the page in the top menu. So okay, now I'm ready to add my Instagram app. So click on social and find the app, and then click on settings, then connect account and type in your username and password. And settings, and you can change the layout. Additional settings and design. Now, every time you upload a picture on Instagram, it will automatically appear here. These type of widgets can be powerful tools. So if your web page is really long, I recommend inserting an anchor menu like this one. Go to add menu, scroll down to the anchor menus and select one. Visitors can navigate your page with just a simple click, which also allows you to edit the mobile version of your site. So click here and switch to mobile view. Here you can optimize the look of your site when seen on a smartphone or tablet. So now that we're done, it's time to publish the site. And now your website is live, and all this again can be done for free, which is really cool. You do have the option to upgrade your site here. You can connect your site to a professional domain and also remove the Wix brand ads you will find on the free version. So again, I'll put links in the description along with any deals or discounts included there as well to take advantage of any promotions. So feel free to take advantage of that if you like. But otherwise, thanks so much for your time. Really appreciate you guys watching. Stay safe out there, and I'll look forward to seeing you in the next video.